our next match, we're staying with men's singles, and it is Prannoy from India against Kanta Tsuneyama from Japan, unseeded men's singles encounter this one. Well, when we look at the men's singles draw, I can tell you that there's been a great big shock in the top half of the draw, because Dwi Wadoyo, who was promoted from the reserve list, it says there, but I think it was promoted from the qualifying, has beaten the Olympic bronze medalist, Anthony Ginting, in three games, a match just shy of the hour mark. So the top half of the draw has been decided, and we know that Ankar Long, although it doesn't say so there, is seeded. He will be the only seed in the semi-final stage, because the match we are about to watch is all unseeded too. Only three seeds at quarter-final stage in the men's singles. Mind you, we only started with five. But here is Kanta Tsuneyama and Prannoy. Sina Sunil Kumar. So as far as these two are concerned, this will be a fourth meeting that they have met in international competition. And of the previous three, Prannoy has won two of them, including the last, which was in the first round of this event 2 years ago, which was the last Malaysia Masters prior to this year.
Prannoy, wait, please. So, you choose the side. You want to receive, so Prannoy to receive, okay?
So, Prannoy chose to receive, and Tsuneyama got to choose ends. No, says Steen.
No, Tsuneyama won the coin toss and chose ends. And then Prannoy chose to receive.
Okay. Well, it's all got very confusing with the umpire calling them back and anyway, here is Hasina Sunil Prannoy. Will turn 30 later this month, in 9 days to be precise, born in Kerala, southwestern coast of India. Went up two places in the world ranking this week to number 19, but as you can see, he has been as high as 8, 4 weeks in total across two different spells at number 8 in the world. In the first round, he beat Bruce Lovadays, and again, it says promoted from the reserves. It should be promoted from qualifying Bruce Lovadays, and then two straight games against Wang Suwei, which was quite extraordinary because he was 5-10 down in the second game and went to 19-12 up, so 14 of 16 points. Extraordinary match it was. So to Kanta Tsuneyama, 26 years of age, turned 26 last month from Saga Prefecture in Western Honshu. 14 on the world ranking at the moment, 16 weeks in total as world number 10. And this is his fourth appearance in this event. And prior to this year, had never previously been beyond the first round. So that's a big improvement. First round, he beat Zhao Zhongpeng, the left-hander from China, who was a beaten finalist at the Indonesia Super 1000 event, and then beat the defending champion, the number 2 seed, Kento Momota, another left-hander, in yesterday's encounter. 21-15, 21-16 against his teammate. So our court officials from Vietnam and Korea. One of their previous three encounters, these two players, twice it's gone the full distance. And given the conditions here, I wouldn't be at all surprised if we went to three games again in this match.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Kanta Tsuneyama, Japan. And on my left, Prannoy, India. Kanta Tsuneyama, love all, play.
So Kanta Tsuneyama of Japan, far side of the court, this last men's singles quarterfinal. Tsuneyama last year had a terrific win at the French Super 750 event, beat Chou Tien Chen in the final. Oh my goodness me. Fresh aired it. Lost the wind, the lights, or maybe the swirl of the drift. Oh, that's extraordinary. No, he wasn't watching the shuttle, that was his problem. Good defence. Yeah, landed well in. Now Tsuneyama. After his good win last autumn in Paris, has only played two tournaments this year. He's been struggling. Now, he pulled out last week. Do you know why he pulled out?
I don't know.
Of the Malaysian Open, having played the Indonesian Open, where he lost in the first round to Victor Axelsen, 8-4.
Yeah, that's one of those sorry to disturb matches. Yeah. Barely managed to go on court before.
Yeah.
Free to go out again. No, I don't know why he withdrew.
There's been a number of players that have had to withdraw this week because of COVID.
Yeah.
I wonder if he had it last week.
That's a possibility.
Yeah.
A couple of formulations so far this week.
He's been in the final this year. Prannoy reached the Swiss Open final. That was his second Swiss Open final. He had been winner of the event in Basel in 2016. Yeah. That lost this year to Jonathan Christie. You were there, Steve. You called that final, I believe.
Yeah, Christie played really well. Prannoy played well also when it was his first final in a long, long time. And it's so good to see him back at this level. And
yeah,
I think basically him going back to this level is well, there's many keys, because you can take each player. Srikant going back to his level is also a key to the Indian Thomas Cobb triumph. But Prannoy as the third men's singles in the form that he's in here, I actually think that he's perhaps the most talented of the Indian men's singles players. But he's never really been able to play for two straight seasons without an injury.
Yeah, he has been beset with injury problems.
On the world,
yeah, right. In the semi-final, but Momota had to pull out.
And he beat Momota yesterday as well.
Yeah.
So then it's a given thing. Tsuneyama is going to win it. If it only was that easy to predict. It's been strange because, I mean, last week, Walter, he had a fairly easy road to the final, but then again, not because he played in Cologne and won a hot 4-3 game match, and he totally destroyed Vitesan. And then he got totally destroyed himself in the final. So what are we to make of all that? It's very difficult to... What we can say is that there's a lot of players that are playing very inconsistently, except Victor Axelsen.
Yeah. He's working hard, is Tsuneyama. Consistent year, Prannoy, hasn't he, this year? And not only that, final in the Swiss Open, semi-final of the Indonesian Super 1000 event, 4 quarterfinals. He's had a couple of first-round losses as well, but, you know, he's regularly getting to quarterfinals or better, has been this year.
Yeah.
That's probably the most consistent that he's been, I think, in the first 6 months of the year. I haven't checked it, but...
But he is playing a lot of tournaments in a row, and that was what was missing.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's some funny first round losses because it's to Vitesan, that's understandable in All England. Then it's to Junwei Cham, 17-7 in Korea Open. And then Thailand Open, Darren Liu, the assistant coach of DC Jha. So, it's matches where. He could have hoped for a win in the first rounds, but he's been consistent in all the others where he's had tougher opposition.
The damage, the block across court from Prannoy.
Serving low ball.
shot.
Wow. That's excellent.
Played with that marking and that control, it's a beautiful shot because it gets help from the from both the drifts, both the one alongside the court and the sideways drift. It becomes a really, really fast attack. And that's at least the second time he's placed it there. Tsuneyama.
Is with Prannoy here at the mid-game interval. That's very, very good judgment. Wow! My goodness, that was close. Perfect judgment. Hear anything there from Prannoy's coach?
No, I couldn't hear what they were saying. I don't know if they are speaking a local language. I couldn't even hear that, whether they spoke English or in a dialect.
Built the rally well, didn't he, Prannoy?
That's what he's so good at. He's so good at constructing the rallies. And I was just thinking earlier on in this first game that he was able to better his defense. We saw how big an impact it's made for Mitraxison's game, that he feels secure. Prannoy into top 10. Has he been there before?
Yes, he has.
Yeah.
It's up as high as 8. Back in 2018. Total of 4 weeks. A few different spells. Player from India so far has contested the men's singles final at the Malaysian Masters. Do you remember that, Steen?
The Malaysian Masters?
Yeah.
I don't remember it, though.
Yeah.
Samir Verma?
8 years ago. Who?
Verma.
Which one?
Samir?
No.
I thought I should have changed it when you asked me. Surat.
Yeah. Lost to Simon Santoso.
It looks something with the looks of Prannoy on court. Either he's nervous or he's nursing some kind of injury, or he can't figure out what to do. There's something that doesn't look right. I can't figure out exactly what it is or what it means.
That's a great shot, my goodness. What an angle and what precision. Take a look at this. Wow.
Concentrated Prannoy.
Well, I just can't, that's a wonderful judgment game. I just had four straight points for Tsuneyama, and the response has been four straight points from Prannoy.
Right.
13-14 down to 17-14 up.
And also, I mean, if the remaining players, these two here on court, and then the three that are already in the semi-final, if they look, if they take a look around and say, okay, who's left here in the tournament, then they should ask themselves, why not me?
Yeah.
Why shouldn't I win it?
Yeah. Let's go wide. Took it.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is important.
It's going well wide.
Yeah. I think he knows the sideways just comes in there. That's probably what's tricked him. Tricked his mind.
I thought it was right to left. No? It's left.
Left to right towards the umpire's chair.
Okay.
Good defense. Three shots earlier by Tsuneyama. That one. Advantage and 2 points away from this opening game. Yeah.
shot from Tsuneyama at the net court.
See that. Coach.
Back level. Who's going to have the game point? The answer is Tsuneyama. On a run of three straight points, he now has a game point opportunity. Saved. Excellent from Prannoy, and 20 all. An extra point required, and so it's a clear 2-point winning margin. Base position to play the round the head smash.
From the last two rallies and the celebrations that we've seen Prannoy make, I think he's been very, very nervous ahead of this match here, and trying to sort of hold it. And not become too emotional whether you play a good or a bad rally.
Yeah. So having saved a game point a moment ago, now Prannoy has a game point himself.
Totally played with the left shoulder to the net, so very difficult to read for the opponent. Beautiful shot.
Shot from Prannoy. That's, you were talking about that in the last match, the hold and flat push from the front of the court when playing from this near side of the court. Second game point opportunity for Prannoy. And the second one is well saved.
Service over. 22,
gone wide. Will it be third time lucky? That Tsuneyama has saved. He's played a winning smash down the forehand side of Prannoy.
No, not all of them.
Are you sure?
I think it was a. Oh, yeah, maybe the winning.
The winning.
The decisive smash down this outline in his forehand and then follow up the win. Yeah, you might be right.
On that. So fourth game point opportunity now for Prannoy. Challenge. Virtually impossible for us to see from our position, but I had a feeling it was in.
All right.
Yep.
Wow.
Opening game. On his fourth game point opportunity, having saved a game point. Prannoy of India, 25-23, opening game against Kanta Tsuneyama. What an excellent opening game. Just under 28 minutes. Nice game. So one game to the goods. Prannoy has seen a Sunil come up. What a thrilling opening game coming from that game point down. So what's Tsuneyama got to do here, Steve? Turn this around.
Yeah, he's going to basically do what we talked about Joel needed to do. put pressure on the backcourt area, small deception to the front court, overcall the front court himself, and hope that Prannoy can't hit the backcourt with accuracy. But I think that Prannoy can hit the backcourt with accuracy. He's in my opinion, got the technical skills to do it. And then one of the things that I feel could become a challenge for Tsuneyama is to score points here. We saw that forehand side, his attack from his forehand side to watch Prannoy was really good. And that's a good smash from the backhand side. Was that too short or was it just, oh, that was way too short. So if Prannoy plays short, then he's got to go on the attack. And I don't think Prannoy's defense is of the same quality as his offensive play. So I think it's an advantage for Tsuneyama to be on the attack. That was a very messy explanation. So move around in the back court corners, mixed with deceptive blocks to the net, and when he gets the opportunity, then attack once or twice, see if something good happens, otherwise back to chasing Prannoy around.
It's a beautiful backhand from Sudirman.
Yeah.
Oh, it's called in. Oh, it was. Really. Now, what's he's saying something to the umpire? We're watching that again. But he's gone to speak to the umpire, Prannoy.
Wants the medical team to do something.
Got some strapping on, or he needs some strapping, or deputy referee Ramati over there, and so the attendant, she's got the jacket on. And we can't actually see what's going on there.
With his foot that was not diagnosed correctly, it took a long time. Is there a thing called foot porn?
Yes. I can tell you that was his left foot. And he had a porn problem. Okay. So I think they've said that he can have some strapping or something at the mid-game interval. But it has to probably be done by his coach.
Yeah, that sounds reasonable.
Yeah. Because the coach has actually left his coaching position.
Yeah, so he's probably going to fetch some spot tape.
Yeah. So, 4-0, right to play.
Could be a blister or something.
Yeah. Prannoy under enough pressure there, Tsuneyama. There's deep forehand corner.
He's got a very quick swing, and it's difficult to judge.
Yeah, that's a nice angle too.
This little break could very well have played on Tsuneyama's mind, saying, okay, so he's a little bit injured, but is it a lot or is it just little, and how should I play safer? Or it's always difficult to figure out exactly what to do. But still scoring points.
Well, he challenges Tsuneyama. Line judge made the right call. You got an opinion?
No.
It's only 50-50.
Yeah, it's 50-50 now. I played lit.
Got him into trouble more than anything else. Yeah. missed it. Back level. Backhand corner, then forehand net, and then he attacked down Prannoy's backhand side. That's what you call making him twist and turn. Moving the full diagonal first of all.
Getting him away from the mid-court area where he's been playing a lot of shots from when Tsuneyama just plays downwards and a little bit short or into the front court. I think he's somehow limited in his movement or in pain when he moves fast.
Missed it.
Prannoy, that was nothing.
On a run of five straight points, Tsuneyama has a two-point advantage at the mid-game interval. So I think the team physio or doctor for India has come on. So we still don't know what the problem is. So the run of points is finally broken. Oh my goodness, backhand smash. Yeah. But what a beautiful, beautiful final shot from Prannoy.
11-4.
Trying to play a Lucy Jar backhand smash with full pirouette.
It's a cheap comment to say now that you feel that he's moving a little bit better. I think we need to see more. Before we can judge if he's playing more freely than before the interval. That's landing well in.
Way. Is having little runs of points. And there doesn't seem to be a logical reason for that.
Well, except if Prannoy feels better on the right foot now. Could also have been a nail sort of touching the skin of one of the other toes.
But presumably the doctor could have dealt with that.
Yeah. Are you allowed to get treatment?
Well, what's cold spray if it's not treatment?
Exactly. That's why I feel that we need some much clearer rules for medical breaks.
Was played from about three-quarter court.
Understandable, as Tsuneyama has an easier task of playing the full court. He's almost already back in mid-court area, not committing fully to that one.
On the left too. Look where his feet are. Makes the smash even better.
Good shot. Excellent play. Nice Tsuneyama.
Serve. We haven't seen many of those, have we, in this match? Oh. Wonderful again. He raises his arm aloft, and I'm not surprised. I just get the sense that might prove pivotal rally. Look at that, just inside the line. And the longest rally of the second game. Had a rally of 35 shots in the opening game.
Tsuneyama.
3-point cushion and 3 points away from forcing a third and deciding game. Tsuneyama, yeah, clearly in.
I don't like Prannoy's service return. Oh, this one I actually like better. His forehand return, he's played so many times. Too kind of that. Doesn't really accomplish anything. But the backhand, you can set a little deception on it. You actually play four corners with ease. That's more like it. Good shot.
Really upping his pace of movement, Tsuneyama. Look at this. Oh. Oh, what on earth is he trying to play with that backhand? And in the bottom of the net, barely made the net. It's extraordinary. To be breathing heavily, does Kanta Tsuneyama. Missed
it.
Yeah, it was off balance when he played that one, Prannoy. Angle from Prannoy.
Have an extra gear, this is definitely now. They should switch.
Oh, indecision.
Mid-court.
Yeah, you're right, Steve. The shuttle got deflected by hitting the top of the tape. That attacking shot from Tsuneyama made it virtually impossible for Prannoy to time his defensive shot. So it's two game point opportunities now for Kanta Tsuneyama to level this quarter final. Now, one game apiece. Oh, it's going to be plumb on the line too, isn't it? Well saved. Brilliant. Two game points well saved by this man, Prannoy. Plenty all, and as with the opening game, extra points required. So there's a clear 2-point winning margin. Wow, this is extraordinary.
Yeah.
Having been two game points down, now Prannoy has a match point opportunity. Prannoy on a run of four straight points initially saves two game points before winning in two straight games. 22-20 the second game, and Tsuneyama, well, he will rue the opportunities missed. Game point opportunities in both games for Tsuneyama. But you've got to hand it to Prannoy, who weathered the storm and won on, as I say, those four straight points. Well, some brave play as well to save those game point opportunities. Well, what a match, and Prannoy through to a third semi-final of the year. Quarter finalist at this event 10 years ago, here in 2022, at least one better. 25-23, 22-20, the margin of his victory in a match lasting exactly 1 hour. So welcome back to quarterfinals day here at the Malaysia Masters Super 500 event on the HSBC BWF World Tour. After those two singles, we now finish with doubles all the way. And our next match is women.